Good day everyone, this is Frost and this is Frost Moto. First, thank you God for allowing this to happen, and second, bro Marvin, thank you for allowing me to borrow and review your bike. So before we begin, you know what to do. If you're on motorcycle, push subscribe button, and if you want updates, push the notification bell. And intro.
So let's have a sound check. Mufflers, Liu vents, aftermarket, no resonator, straight. So catalytic is removed. Alright. Okay.
Alright, so what we have here is the QJ SRK 400 2024, price at 318,000.
So alright, so instead that I'm going to do my destination review, I'm gonna do it in a test drive because it's Sunday evening right now and there are a lot of people doing some, groups of riders doing some town bike, and we all know what's gonna happen. They're revving their engine, they're talking loudly, so I couldn't focus and you cannot hear me as well. So I'm gonna continue it while driving and get back, maybe they are gone. Let's start the engine and let's begin. So alright, so let's have a test ride. So this is a POV, so we're gonna use the SRK 400. Let's go directly. So I know some of you are wondering if the QJ, let's just be honest guys, some of us are not really into motorcycles, some of us just beginning the journey. So if you're gonna ask QJ Motor, so QJ is a Chinese company, the answer to that question is yes, QJ Motor is a Chinese company, but not your typical Chinese company. They actually have a very good track record to prove it or to back up it, and also they own a lot of very famous companies. You can actually check that. So that means that they are actually a really good company to be able to survive that and to have a very good standard, especially knowing that Chinese companies are not that good in terms of quality. And right now, they are already partnered with Harley Davidson. So we all know Harley Davidson in terms of, you know, expensive quality and a very long track record also. So they are trying to get entry into the Asian market by QJ Motor by producing 300 to 500cc displacement engine to Harley Davidson. So the same engine that I am using right now, the SRK 400. So the SRK 400 is a new contender here in the Philippines, but in other country, precisely India, they're already there for I believe years already. So in India, they are also famous, especially in the entry category, and they are, and we all know in India, KTM is very famous, especially the Duke 290. So a lot of bloggers there are doing some comparison between the two bikes. And again, so let's say that you're a beginner rider and you're looking for an inline four, but you're afraid of, maybe it's for the price, second is how powerful the engine. So because you're a beginner rider, so you're looking for at least a 400cc that can get you to places from places and also can go from expressway. So the SRK 400 is a very good choice because number one, it sounds like an inline four, as you can hear in the video, especially as it starts or idle, it growls like an inline four. Second is, it's not that powerful, so it's good for beginner riders, especially lady riders also are very good by riding this one. Also, if you're looking for a sound, then this one is really for you. Second is the price, it's not that expensive, considering if you're gonna consider it between the other competition. So now let's go back to the engine. So the SRK 400 is using a 360 firing order or 360 degree crankshaft. So this is just my own opinion. I'm not trying to argue, I'm not trying to tell you which one is good, which one is better. This is just my own explanation. So if you're going to ask me, 360 for me is not that good, especially in this kind of displacement, because 360 is actually good in bigger displacement or an inline four, but a two-cylinder is actually good. For me, it's not that kind of balance in terms of power output, but it's a very good idle, it has a very good torque. But if you're going to ask me in this kind of displacement, I will go into the 180 degree. For number one, better power output. Second, in terms of balance and revolution, I consider that one far more better compared with the 360. I'm not saying that 360 is not efficient. All I'm saying is, between my own opinion, I will go with the 180 for better power output and for the less vibration, because in the 360 crank, both piston goes up, both piston goes down. You can actually add a balancer to make it smoother, but just trying to imagine the engine design, especially in high rev, it produces more vibration compared with the 180. That's my explanation for that. So I'm not trying to argue, I'm just trying to tell you my own opinion. Also, there's a reason why right now in the 300cc to 700cc category, most of the companies are using the 180 firing, and you cannot see any 360. In the past, it is very famous and widely used, but now it has been obsolete because of the power output and also for the balance and in terms of the RPM limit. 360 again is very good, especially in higher displacement, but in the 400cc category, I highly doubt that kind of power. So instead, for me, I will go with the 180. But for you as a consumer, beginner rider, at least try considering this one, especially if you really want the engine noise of the inline four. And for me, one of the nice things about this one, or my pros, is number one, the agility of the bike, second, the weight, and third, I mean, again, to be honest with you, in the 400cc, the noise, if you're really that kind of person that want to show off or thumb bike noise, then this one is very much for you. So the engine noise is actually very nice. You can see that in my video. I'm gonna show you again a video in the tunnel just to make sure, just to give you an idea. So finish this video to the last. And even though it is using a cable for its throttle, it is actually very responsive. So the moment that you rev the throttle, it gives you the exact amount of power that you want. So for me, that's a bonus point. So I'm just gonna add, there are actually a lot of reviews about this one, far more better than me in terms of explaining things, but I just wanna share to you my honest opinion. So I guess that's it. So let's go to the engine specs so we can tell you furthermore about this specification. Alright, so let's go for its engine spec. So it is a 400cc, two-cylinder, 360 crank firing, where both piston goes up and both piston goes down, liquid-cooled, 4-stroke, 4 valves, dual overhead cam, and a 6-speed transmission. So as you can see here, one nice thing about this one is the coolant is very accessible. You can see the level, you're not gonna go into tight places like some coolant are put here, you can open the fairings. That for me is very accessible. Okay, so clean sensor. What else? Okay, trailless frame. I'm not sure if this is trailless frame. Okay, suspension. Everything is actually very decent enough to be able to see what's inside. So that makes the naked bike one nice thing. Temperature sensor. Temperature sensor or this is sensor for the radiator to start. Let's go for the other side. So for its bore and stroke, it is 70.5 millimeter, and for its stroke, it is 51.2 millimeter. That gives you a max power of 30.5 kW at 9,000 RPM. For its max torque, it provides you a 37 Newton meter at 7,500 RPM, and the compression ratio is 11:8:1. So what we see here is the ABS module. Okay, sensor. So this is the engine design. See for its headers. So going back to both headers, I don't know if it's connected. Yes, it's connected with the middle part. Oh, radiator. Radiator guard. Very nice radiator guard actually. So let's go for the other details. And for its fuel capacity and tires, it is actually 13.5 liters fuel injected. And I have no idea about the consumption, but based on other people, it consumes very well for a 400cc. And for its rotor disc in the front, it is dual disc 2016mm. And for its calipers, it is actually a QJ motor. But based on what other people say, they actually said it is somewhat similar to a Brembo in terms of quality. I'm not certain about that one. So for the rear, it is actually 240mm, and for its caliper, it is still QJ motor. So it's not bad for its braking system. It provides you with the stopping power that you really want. If you saw my earlier video, you can actually see that. So for the tires, for the rear, it is actually 150x60x17, but the owner upgraded it to 180 just to make it look like a big bike. And for the front, it is actually 110 by 70 by 17 and the stock tires is Maxxis. So in terms of stock tire, it is actually still good.
So let's check for the display. Side mirror is actually nice, but if you're going to ask me, I'm gonna do it with a bar end because this is a naked bike. It makes it more sleek and aesthetically nice. So grips is actually good, not that expensive, but not that poor. So buttons are nice, crisp, high beam, now passing light, select button, high beam and low beam, turning indicators, horn, right side, kill switch, ignition and start. So this one has a hazard. For the brakes, you can actually adjust the lever, but for the clutch, you cannot. But even though it has no as a slipper clutch, it is actually very nice, very light. But maybe in the future, for its price, they could actually add as a slipper clutch because for easy downshifting. So for the display, this is what it looks like. Again, yeah. So this is a TFT display already, based on them. So gear, temperature, fuel, RPM, speed. For the bottom, it is still RPM. Chicken gen, oil, and ABS. Odometer. So select. If you check select, actually change to trip A and trip B. Enter. So this is the interface. You can actually change it to, you know, to light. Brightness, unit information, Bluetooth, TPS interface. Okay, so I guess that's it, guys. We don't have enough time to check it one by one. So this is what it looks like. Okay, so for its key, this is the key, the QJ. So they have been very famous with this one. And actually, tuck it in. And it is like a knife. Okay, alright. So let's go for the other details.
For the rear suspension, can be the preload can be changed. You can actually adjust that one. But I guess that's it, guys. And if you want to make it softer, you can actually change the oil. For the front, it is just a standard upside down suspension. But at least it's an upside down suspension. So in terms of cornering, it can give you some enough quality suspension ride. So guys, again, what you see is what you get. The frame is very naked, you can actually see that. So in terms of cleaning your bike, it's very easy. So you got here some QJ motor. So this is just a sticker, so you need to be careful of that one because some user of this, their sticker got removed.
So one nice thing about this one, guys, is when you buy the bike, it has already a spool included, so no need for you to look up from the aftermarket. So foot pegs are actually nice rubber. But the rubber is, I think it's about to get, the rubber is about to get off. Alright, so foot peg. So the purpose of this one is an indicator for your maximum leaning corner. So shifter. Rectifier is here, so at least if you're going to fix this one, everything is accessible. That's a bonus point for the mechanics. Starter motor. So it's our key logo here. So let's check for the inside of the seat. So this is what it looks like. It's going to remove the pillion seat. Some Allen here, star Allen. So you can put anything except for your ORCR. So if you're going to open this one, the battery is in the inside. So I don't know how to open this one. So maybe in the future na lang. So we have some QJ motor logo here. So right, so key sticker. So the owner, the Tiltide, did this already. So as you can see, it's very sleek. So this is what it looks like from the distance. This is the 360. For the seat, actually it's nice for its standard, for its stock. No need for you to change it. But for the rear, as per the owner, it actually it's kind of painful, especially in the long ride. So we added some extra foam for it to become more soft. So the doors here, you have some holes here for extra aerodynamics. I don't know if it's functioning. But the purpose of this in the big bikes or in litter bikes is extra downforce or aerodynamics. Front, okay. I guess that's it, nothing much. What you see is what you get. But for the light, this is actually LED. Everything is LED. Turning indicators are all LED. Right, so let's go for its seat height. So let's go for its dimension. So again, I am 5'11". Seat height is 785 millimeter. So as you can see, I'm flat-footed. Ground clearance is 150 millimeter. So very nice in some sort of off-roading. And for its curb weight, it is 186 kilogram. So actually, it's nice. So this is what it looks like if you're gonna be 5'11". So if you're an average Filipino, like 5'5", this actually fits for you. So the suspension play in the rear is actually nice. Very soft, but for the front, it's kind of hard. So I think you need to adjust it, change the oil or something. So again, guys, that's it. This is what it looks like if you're riding the SRK 400. So that's enough. Let's go.
So guys, this was a very hard review of all my reviews because everything was just in out of order because there are people, you know, going in thumb bikes and they are very loud, so I couldn't focus. Some audios are very loud, so I'm terribly sorry guys, but I really did my best. So I hope that still you love this review, but if you do, please push the subscribe button, and if you end up, please push the notification bell. So enjoy the rest of the video. Thank you so much. God bless and ride safe.